and Kelly back with you, and today we're going to talk about meal planning. I know, Kelly, it's so frustrating, especially to the young moms out there. How do I do all this? How do I get the kids done with their homeschool and put food
not
on the table?
Not just the young moms.
I know, us old moms too. I have to say, we do love our Instant Pot. There's so many good ideas out there, so many. And I know you had mentioned Instant Pot before. You use yours a lot.
Oh, I love my Instant Pot. The crock pot takes so much time.
It does. It does.
It takes way too much prep time for me.
We want everything fast.
I do. I want it fast. And the crock pot, I have to think ahead.
Yeah.
The Instant Pot, I can say at 3 o'clock, oh, I need a meal. And I can throw it in my Instant Pot and it's ready at 5 o'clock. So now when they say in the Instant Pot, have your chicken in 20 minutes, they're not counting.
I know.
Like, I feel the
time for it to heat up.
Yeah.
And the time for it to cool
exactly.
down. And that's a little deceptive.
I feel like they're a little deceptive because it does cook in 20 minutes.
Yes.
But it's more like 40.
Yes.
So let's be honest. Okay. Be real. It is more like 40.
Yes.
But it's not 4 hours.
It's not. And you can take frozen chicken.
Exactly.
And make it barbecue shredded chicken.
In 40 minutes.
In 40 minutes.
You can really do it. In 40 minutes.
Yes.
So, yes, I do love my Instant Pot.
We love having a few solid meals that our family just likes and trying to scheduling them out during the week. In fact, my husband and I have gotten on this rhythm now where we use our weekly trip to the grocery store as our date, which is really nice.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, I mean, it's fun because we do have children who are older who could stay home. So hopefully you do. If not, maybe somebody else can grab your kids. But, you know, it's so important to still have that weekly date time with your hubby through homeschooling. You just need the support and to vent, and you just need that time. And so, sort of like killing two birds with one stone, because you get into the habit of what you need every week.
Yeah.
Yeah, not that it's an obligation to have your date time with your husband and you have to kill two birds with one stone, but it's just, it is so nice. And so that's what we get to. We get to grocery store dates with our husbands.
Hey. We've gotten into Saturdays. We'll sit down and we write down our meal. Just a handwritten, this is what we're going to have every day. And I try to make it an Instant Pot meal or crock pot meal. But more times than not, an Instant Pot meal or 20 minute where I can throw it together at lunchtime. Or I will be honest again, he does more cooking than I do.
Oh, that's nice.
He's the cook in the house.
And we know that you have a daughter who does the dishes. So what are you doing, Cal?
Eat my bonbons on my couch.
Of course,
I'm sitting on my couch eating my bonbons. But no, he does do a majority of the cooking. I've been trying to get better at that.
Oh, that's wonderful.
But it is what it is.
Yeah, it's good.
But yeah, so we will try to sit down and plan it out. And so when the kids are at lunchtime, what's for dinner?
Yeah.
Go look at the
you have an answer.
Yeah. Go look at the calendar on the refrigerator.
Yeah. Well, in all honesty, in our home, sometimes when kids say that, we say, it's a fend for yourself night.
Yes.
And I think that's okay. Yeah. Cereal. Every once in a while, it's okay to have cereal or
fend for yourself.
Eggs or something for
Sunday evenings are our fend for yourself.
Yeah. Oh, good. Good. Yeah. Well, that's good in your house. Her husband is a pastor, so you really don't want to be cooking the big meals on Sunday.
Nope, we have our big meal on Sunday afternoons after church, and then Sunday evenings are a fend for yourself.
So the other thing that I think is helpful, if you can do it, I just started doing this probably this year. I found somebody locally. Actually, the Lord just brought us together, but she will go out when she does her own grocery shopping. She will go out and purchase items for things that we've ordered. She cooks it all, and then she charges $10 a meal to make it for us.
That's so awesome.
It really, really is. Even just to have some in the freezer, you know, for those nights when you cannot pull it together. There's a lot of women, too, that I think do like once a week cooking or even once a month cooking. I think those ones are pretty rare.
Those are rare, yeah.
Once a month cooking. Then you probably have a high electric bill and you really panic when you have an outage.
Yeah. Have you ever done the co-ops? Where a couple of moms get together and one mom hands out a recipe to each of the other moms, and that mom is responsible. So say five moms get together.
Yeah.
And each mom has one recipe.
Who chooses the recipes?
Each mom chooses one recipe.
Okay.
And then that mom gets the recipe for five families.
Oh.
And then you all get together, and then you send the recipes out, and then you all get together, and you make that one recipe for each family.
For five people. For five families.
For five families. You make that one recipe for five families, but then when you leave, you have a week's worth of food, because then you give your recipe to that family. And then, so when you leave, you have five.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
It is kind of cool.
If you have issues like gluten-free or dairy-free.
Yeah, that
free,
it gets a little complicated if you have all that.
I guess the other thing, too, would be is if you had somebody who had like two or three kids and somebody who had like six or seven kids.
Yeah, it's true. Or you're in the middle of a pandemic and people are afraid
of. And can't
buy. Yeah.
Remember that?
I have no idea what you're talking about. COVID, Corona. We're not in any. Yeah.
Oh, no. Just like you couldn't get food. You couldn't get any food, and then everybody's wiping their groceries. And the other thing that we do, Kelly, is we, you know, I've talked about scheduling before. We'll put on our schedule to have the kids have a meal prep night. So depending on their age, they might be doing hot dogs and french fries, but it's still getting them into the rhythm of here's how we boil water and put hot dogs in and count how many people are going to be home and get the rolls out and turn the oven on and put the
fries in.
Yeah, you know, a 17-year-old is much different in capabilities than an 11-year-old, but so we'll try to each night say, okay, you know, who's on meal prep tonight, and some of them need more help than others, but I just think it's helpful because you're growing them all in the direction of helping and having independent skills that they'll take on to their own families.
We do something similar in that we have five kids, and there's 7 days in the week, and so each one of our kids has what's their day, and we go by age order. So Shyla has Monday, Austin has Tuesday, Gabe Wednesday, no, Abby Wednesday.
You're skipping Abby.
Gabe Thursday, JJ Friday. And when it's your day, you pray for every meal.
Oh.
You feed the animals and your meal prep. And so you get to spend that time with whomever's making meals that day.
Yeah.
And it's really easy then to remember who's meal prep that day. It really eliminates fights, too, because if you're going to the grocery store on Monday, Austin, you get to go because it's Monday. It's your special day. So
that's a great idea.
Yeah, that helps, too. And now, if you have more than seven kids, I don't know what to tell you, but, you know.
Rotation.
That helps, too, just a little.
So hopefully we've given you a few little tips that you can take away and use in your own home. And we'll see you next week. Bye.
God bless and have a great day.